to main, go in.
Four propellers, four rudders. Two, four sets of controls. These are your throttles, the red ones. And then these are forward, neutral, and reverse.
What's your name?
My name is Jerry Jr.
Hi, Jerry. Bill Reeve.
I know.
Nice to meet you.
We have your tack over here.
This is
a
motorbike back in the second state.
And all your oil pressure and gauges.
Seven.
My radar is warming up. Use that when you can't see.
Do you have the awesome party machine on 80?
When it's real foggy or at nighttime. This is, we have two Lorans. You see the numbers? There's two sets of numbers. One of them is a set runs east and west, and the other one runs north and south. And by looking at the Loran chart and taking the numbers,
13, 8, 28, 44, 133. 8, 10, 8, 28, 44, 133.
35, 33.
We're right about here.
How would you rate today's whale watch? Can't get any better than that. One of her best. Going to make sure the naturalist announces that if you come out again, not to expect that. It's very rare. See that many. First of all, seeing a humpback open while feeding is pretty exciting.
Yeah.
Just one. Seeing all that group of them all together.
Coming up
the
in unison.
There was like seven or eight or nine of them.
It was like it was choreographed.
Crazy. They do is they collect a feed instead of. Fighting over the food, they help each other. They all feed at once at the same time. Because there are big schools. I don't know if you saw it one time, they were jumping right out of the water. They do a lot of nice things with Loran. Right now I have Race Point, which is a target that I'm aiming at, hooked in Loran. It'll tell you the bearing from us, the distance, nautical miles from us, how many minutes it'll take you to get there.
At your current speed.
Well, it's velocity towards a destination.
Then
your velocity, towards a destination. To actual course and speed. It varies from your velocity.
Sorry. Your speed now is, what, 16 knots?
16 and a half right now. You can do 21 knots wide open. We cruise at about at 1650 on the tachometers. And she'll turn 2,000 wide open.
So it's interesting, it's a one sort of one-to-one correlation for revolutions to knots. If you're going 1650 and you're 1650 and
pretty close,
yeah.
She'll go up when we get around the race point off New Beach between Race Point and Wooden. She might go up to 17 and a half, 18 knots, depending on the current. When you're fighting the current can be very strong in that area, especially up around the race. Up to 4 knots. Usually it affects you about 1 or 2, 1.5, 2 knots.
So you got a little,
To 16.8 already.
But it's still the same RPM.
Yeah. It is a radar. Okay, right now, it's light out, so you need to cover. You can see, all that land in the radar. And when we get get past race bowling, like halfway in between, you'll be able to see the tip of Cape Cod all the way around to here, and on the, all the way around the Churro up the Cape.
Really? Oh, that's incredible.
And it's a relationship to get 90% of the rules of the road, which is extremely difficult test. If this seamanship, weather, navigation, first aid, firefighting, buoys, rules of the road, charting, plotting, courses, it's an extremely difficult test.
How much of it is book and how much of it is real experience?
I guess. If you study, I guess you, if you just studied, you could pass the test.
Without ever getting out of the boat.
Yeah, but you have to have 735 days signed by an owner of a vessel.
Oh, okay.
Or several vessels. And you have to be, I think, I forgot what it was, like 25% of that, those days have to be within the last, in the last 2 years or something like that when you have to take the test. You have experience.
Oh, it's fantastic. I've been out on a few whale watches, and I was on one where we had a group of seven or eight who were putting on a similar kind of show. They were doing a lot of flapping on the side with the fins and a lot of tail slapping,
yeah.
And just putting on a real show for us all afternoon. And a lot of dives, deep dives. But I hadn't seen so much breaching, so much. They did a little bit of it, not a whole lot. This is out of Gloucester, a couple years back. But I never had one come underneath the boat. That was incredible.
Oh, yesterday morning, we had a cow and calf humpback. We shut off all the engines and drifted for an hour. They wouldn't leave the boat. Sometimes they wrap themselves on the boat. They were like 5 feet away, 3 feet away the whole time, just going up one side, back down the other, going underneath, coming back and forth, blowing, getting the people all wet. The past 3 weeks have been incredible. That was the first time I've had a close approach this year. The whales usually go, they have to shut off the engines and they stay with you.
That doesn't happen
too often. I've seen it like maybe 20 times.
Uh-huh.
There was some breaching today. They jumped totally out of the water.
Uh-huh.
When we were coming up to them, I could see a big, huge splash in the distance. One or two times, that was it.
That's incredible.
Last night we had some breaching. They seem to be coming down from up north. Every night, the past 3 nights. 25, 30
whales,
humpbacks, coming down. And right around here, I better watch out.
Yeah,
there's a finback right there. There's another one over there.
We were out in Race Point the other day and watching them, you know, just offshore.
You went down, you won't get them last year, they didn't come up. There's so much bait up here this year that they're everywhere. One day, there's like we already see one, two, maybe three humpbacks, finbacks all the time. Then one day, all of a sudden, all 17 moved up. One day. And that was like the best whale watch, the most in one area I've ever seen since I was knee high. They were everywhere you look, right in the middle. Breaching, jumping out of the water, flipping flat, tail lobbing, open mouth feeding. Every trick in the book.
How much do you and the other boat owners communicate about where you're finding them?
Well, some companies like to keep to themselves and private radios, and they don't really share the information. Most everybody else, I think that, yeah, everyone else shares information with each other on where the whales are and stuff. Most all the other boats. We usually have boats from Plymouth and Captain John's and all the three companies out of here, and then this company here. Diana's Whale Watch, a friend of mine, my parents. But they have to come all the way across the harbor, about an hour and 15 minutes just to get to where we are right now. So it's a long boat ride, especially when it's rough.
Yeah.
It makes it terrible. When it's flat calm, it's all right. Like today.
Yeah, it's
beautiful. There was really big rollers out there. Like big rollers, long. There's tons of whales ahead of us right now. I might have to slow down.